Hello everyone, and today we have a very depressing video for you. How many times could we solve the housing crisis using various government spending? So previously we had a video where we calculated, or I calculated, about $28 billion worth of housing needs to be constructed to solve the housing crisis. So if you go up here, here's the mathematics. I'm not going to go over it. You can just pause it right now, but there's the source number. 4,500 acres, about $30 billion. So, let me just revert here. Okay, nice. So, we have our war on drugs. This is all sourced from the internet, all these different costs. War on drugs, $1,000 billion. This is for pretty much the whole thing. 35 times we could solve housing. This is really simple. You just divide. War on terror, 220 times. And then this would be a percent of total right here. So you just take the inverse. About 3% of the war on drugs would solve the housing crisis. 0.5% of the war on terror. Our COVID stock market bailout, 105 times, would solve the housing crisis. Trump COVID stimulus, 77. Biden COVID stimulus 1, 66. Biden COVID, this is the infrastructure plan that they're currently still debating, 2.3 trillion. That's 80 times it could solve the housing crisis. This is where it gets ugly. The total 2008 Federal Reserve bailouts, this is all of the bond purchases, the asset purchases, shoring up everything from the 2008 financial crisis, $29 trillion. 1,000 times. This is 0.1% of the total would solve the housing crisis. Just this. It doesn't include everything else we're talking about. This is just for these itemizations, mind you. So just 0.5% would solve housing crisis. Just 1.5% of just this bill would solve the housing crisis. We have our annual federal budget for 20 years and our annual federal state and local for 20 years. That's $4 trillion each, so $80 trillion each times 20. Each of these, 2,800 times, it would solve the housing crisis. 0.036%. Now you just total all of these together. We're looking at $200 trillion worth of government spending. None of it goes towards affordable housing. Zero. Not since the 60s, I believe. They stopped doing that. That is 7,200 times we could have solved the current housing crisis for a total of 0.014% of our total government spending is what it costs. Still can't do it. Still, unfortunately, can't do it. Now, this was a lower estimate. The $30 billion is a lower estimate. The high-end estimate was four times higher. So our worst case scenario from the original video is only 1,800 times we would be able to solve the housing crisis for 0.056, 1 in 2,000 pretty much. 1/2,000th of government spending, worst case scenario, would solve our current housing crisis. So I said this was a very troubling video. And math doesn't lie, ladies and gentlemen. This is the sad truth of our situation. The government will do everything in its power to enrich the middle class and leave the poor behind and leave the workers behind and not do anything to alleviate the material conditions of society. Because they're operating on a problem-reaction-solution. The problem is poverty, which they don't do. They actually create through taxation. Mind you, this is all from taxation, $200 trillion. So they create poverty in the poor and working class by taxing them, and then they do nothing to solve their problems, and then they offer up Marxism as the solution. Don't fall for it, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, that's it. Sorry for ruining your day. And thank you, and try to have a nice day. If you want to see a new and better world come to fruition, as I do, then like, share, and subscribe. You can find an incredible amount of math, knowledge, and 3D renders by clicking on the channel name. And remember, we need you to help spread this vision across the internet for all to see and become familiar with. Let us build this new world together.